السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أول شيء تشرفت بدعوة كريمة من زميلنا الدكتور مازن الدوماني لأن أكون محاضرا ضمن مؤتمر طب الأسنان المباشر الذي يعقد بشكل دوري، فأنا بوجه له جزيل الشكر والعرفان، وإلي الشرف أني أكون معكم بهذا المؤتمر، فيعطيكم العافية جميعا، وإن شاء الله تكون محاضرتي شيقة. محاضرتي will be about vital bulb therapy of permanent teeth with irreversible bulbitis and periapical rarefaction. لمن لا يعرفني، أنا الدكتور محمد القادري، بكالوريوس طب أسنان جامعة العلوم والتكنولوجيا، وحاصل على درجة الماجستير في تخصص علاج العصب والبورد الأردني في تخصص علاج العصب، ومحاضر غير متفرغ في جامعة العلوم والتكنولوجيا، و I have private practice in Jerash. بناء على طلب العديد من الزملاء أن يكون الشرح يعني باللغة العربية، راح أحاول يعني ما استطعت أني الأشياء اللي بعرفها باللغة العربية أني أشرحها باللغة العربية، والأشياء اللي ما بعرفها يعني نحاول نفهمها باللغة الإنجليزية بحيث أنه توصل الفكرة والمسج، وتكون في اشياء نستفيد منها just to be applicable in our dental practice. هلا الكونتروفيرسي انه whether to do انه vital bulb therapy or conventional endodontics. احنا بالزمانات علمونا انه direct bulb capping ما بينفع الا للاسنان الاسيمتوماتيك، وكون السايز اوف bulb exposure very small or very minimal، وكون في عندي hemostasis or bleeding control. But with better understanding of bulb biology and bulb pathophysiology innovation of a new dental biomaterials that are able to enhance the regenerative potential of the dental bulb. تغيرت الأمور وأصبح فهمنا لقدرة العصب السني على الاستجابة للمؤثرات الخارجية تغيرت وصارت أفضل، ومع اختراع المواد طب الأسنان اللي هي biocompatible و it's able to enhance the bulb regeneration، فالموضوع تغير. So the vital bulb therapy treatment approach can be applied also for permanent teeth with irreversible bulbitis and the teeth, even teeth with periapical lesion. وهذا الإشي based on clinical evidence, not on clinical experience. It is based on clinical studies. يعني دراسات سريرية عملت على هذا الموضوع. كنا بنعرف الابيكسوجينيسيس انه احنا وي ار تراينج وين وي هاف ا فايتال بلب والروتس ار اماتشور تو انهانس كومبليت ديفلوبمنت اوف ذا توث روت وي اكسايز بورشن اوف ذا بلب تيشيو اند وي بوت بايو كومباتبل ماتيريال تو انهانس كومبليت روت فورميشن. فهذا المبدأ يعني بعد ما نخلص اور برزنتيشن وي شود بي ايبل وذر تو دو كونفشنال اندودونتكس أو نعمل اللي هو الـ vital bulb therapy treatment. هلأ as we know إنه dental caries is the major threat to the dental bulb with detrimental consequences if left untreated. يعني عندنا تسوس الأسنان إذا if left untreated will go deep into the dentine then will affect the underlying dental bulb and the, leading to inflammation that's called bulbitis. Bulbitis after bulbitis will go into necrosis. Necrosis will lead ultimately into development of periapical abscess or and periapical periodontitis. كنا بنعرف انه the success rate of conventional endodontics is regarding initial treatment it is very high, it is more than 90%. بس كنا بنعرف انه تخصص الاندودونتكس بحد ذاته it's highly demanding. ليش highly demanding? Due to the complex anatomy of the root canal system. حكينا عنه system وليس root canal because we have multiple apical ramifications, we have all root canals are curved, it needs skills, it needs techniques, it needs materials, it needs basic armamentarium should be available for this form of treatment to be successful and highly predictable. وكنا بنعرف انك اذا if we want to deliver a high level of endodontics, the cost of treatment will be high. So في عندنا alternative, في عندنا other treatment options for a treatment of such teeth with inflamed vital bulb and periapical rarefaction. راح نشوف in the upcoming slides. كنا بنعرف انه ال 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 one of the main functions of the bulb هو sensory function، هي وظيفه حسيه وكمان defensive mechanism، وكمان فيه شيء موجود جوا البلب اللي هو البروبريوسبشن. كنا بنعرف انه البروبريوسبتيف نيرف فايبرز كنا نفكر زمان انها موجوده جاست بالبريبيكال تيشو، but with our with better understanding and more clinical research وجدنا انه many studies proved انه التيث اللي هم نون فايتال اور اندودونتيكلي تريتد تيث due to loss of proprioception they are subjected to a higher occlusal load so the fracture resistance will be lower than the vital counterpart. وكمان بنعرف انه the presence وجود البلب او النيرف تيشو inside the dental bulb بيعمل لي damping يعني resiliency، بيعطي resiliency للسن so it's more functional so it is the durability or longevity of this tooth will be better than the root canal treated tooth. هاي الدراسة انعملت عن طريق زميل إنا الدكتور خالد حمدات، ووجد بهاي الدراسة إنه في عندي proprioceptions وقارن بالocclusal load يعني بنفس المريض بسن معمول root canal treatment وسن مو معمول root canal treatment. The result of this study إنه الأسنان إنه patients with root treated teeth they subject their teeth to a higher occlusal load that will lead ultimately to vertical root fracture due to loss of proprioception from the internal bulb. For once this bulb get devitalized or root canal treated, the patient will exert more force. That's mean the tooth will be more prone or more susceptible toward development of vertical root fracture due to loss of proprioceptive nerve fibers. الدايليما بتبلش عندنا بالدياجنوسيس. كنا بنعرف انه final and accurate diagnosis of the bulb status cannot be determined from the subjective and objective data due to poor correlation between these data and the actual histological status. Because the golden standard is to take a specimen from the dentin bulb then subject this specimen for histological assessment, which is not feasible, you know, to open the bulb and take a specimen. So we depend on the results or the information provided by subjective and objective examination. Subjective by listening into the patient about the chief complaint, history of chief complaint. What we mean by objective assessment or examination, we rely on the results of endo-ice vitality testing, palpation, percussion, visualization of the teeth that are carious or traumatized by fracture. So we combine all of these data to reach or to establish diagnosis. Most agree that multiple tests can improve reliability of these tests. حتى هاي التست اللي بتكون يعني روتينلي افيلبل ان اور دنتال اوفيس they are not highly accurate because they are في منهم false positive يعني false negative test result. وما ننسى موضوع التست كافيتي to assess the status of the underlying bulb. We drill the tooth without anesthesia to see whether this tooth bulb is vital or not because the pain threshold between patients is highly variable. Regarding bulb biology and pathology, when the tooth is subjected to caries, it starts from enamel, then it go into dentine. يعني بلش طبقة المينا بعدين للعاج وبروح للون. كان الأول theories إنه stated إنه that the inflammation inside the dental bulb يكون rapid and progressive. بس recent study proved that progression of caries and bulb exposure involve local vascular and tissue alterations restricted to 2 millimeter of the coronal bulb tissue. And this bulb tissue, if removed and excised under a sterile condition, the underlying radicular bulb will be able to heal. لأن ممكن يكون في عندي irreversible bulbitis بالcoronal bulb tissue, whereas the radicular portion of the bulb may be reversibly inflamed. That means it's able to undergo repair and regeneration. Why periapical tissue change precede total bulb necrosis? Because inflammatory mediators cross through the remaining vital bulb tissue and reach the periapical area leading to bone resorption. يعني we have vital teeth with periapical lesion. يكون في عندي well established bone resorption مبين على البريبيكال X-ray. Why? Because due to the concept of neurogenic inflammation. As we know, في عندنا dental nerve fibers, A delta والA beta, وفي عندي C nerve fibers. وفي عندي كمان اللي هو vascular tissue inside. في interaction between these dental nerve fibers once they get excited due to the presence of inflammation, بصير في عندي زي cycle that will perpetuate and leading to more vasodilatation, more release of inflammatory mediators that will cross through the tooth root and reach the periapical area, causing periapical inflammation evidence or visible on the periapical X-ray as bone resorption. And this is the concept of neurogenic inflammation. Because معظم الزملاء بيحكوا الدكتور كيف بتعالج سن vital bulb therapy هو فيه periapical refraction. I tested the bulb by many tests using endo ice, electrical bulb test, test cavity based on the patient complaint, and I confirmed that this tooth bulb is vital. I excised the coronal bulb tissue and I lift the radicular portion of the bulb with minimal bleeding, then proper biocompatible dressing agent applied over this radicular bulb, so healing is expected. As we know that calcium hydroxide is long history or long tract record, because it was developed by Hermann. It was used in vital bulb therapy, especially in direct bulb capping treatment. The newly invented mineral trioxide aggregate, which is based on Portland cement, has been used in bulb therapy since 1990. Maybe 30 years ago, and it was invented by Torabin Jad. Now we have many forms of MTA. يعني في عندنا عدة أنواع من MTA now available at the market, يعني تصنع من أكثر من شركة with different setting times, وفي منهم ال white وفي منهم ال gray to avoid discoloration. Many studies proved إنه MTA is better than calcium hydroxide in term of biocompatibility, in term of physical stability, because it resists dissolution and induces formation of dentin bridge underneath that is of a greater quantity and better quality than that formed underneath calcium hydroxide. So we prefer to use mineral trioxide aggregate or calcium silicate material as a bulb dressing agent rather than using calcium hydroxide due to these added benefits. Regarding use of resin adhesive material over the vital bulb, it is contraindicated. لأن معظم الستاديز نعملوا على healthy bulb وanimal studies. ما في عندي clinical studies على human subjects that proved resin adhesive material as an appropriate bulb capping agent with predictable success rate. ومن studies proved إنه calcium hydroxide is better than resin capping due to its antibacterial and hemostatic function. تمام مش معقول نعمل كابينج ولا اكسبوز بلب with these resin adhesive material. Regarding our research which was conducted by my supervisor Dr. Nasreen Taha, it was conducted between 2011 up to 2014. It was a clinical study وعبارة عن clinical research. It involved teeth with reversible and irreversible bulbitis. ومنا فولو اب لهي الاسنان كلينيكال اند راديوجرافيك فور 3 years. I will talk in the upcoming slides more about my research. Regarding شو الاشياء اللي بتخلي في عندي شروط ومتطلبات ومواصفات should be met for this form of vital bulb therapy, which is complete bulbotomy treatment to be successful. The remaining radicular bulb should be free of inflammation. If I have an active bleeding and reddish in color, that means the underlying radicular bulb is inflamed. It is irreversibly inflamed. It is unable to undergo healing and regeneration. So the vital bulb therapy in such case is contraindicated. So إذا ما كان في عندي proper hemorrhage control, that's mean. وعادة التايم اللي بنعطيه from 5 up to 10 minutes ممكن نستخدم. I will talk about the bulbotomy technique. I use full concentration sodium hypochlorite with cotton billet applied directly into the vital radicular bulb stump. Lift inside the bulb chamber up to 10 minutes. If I have bleeding control, I will proceed with vital bulb therapy. Otherwise, I have to go for bulbectomy or conventional endodontics. إذا صار في عندي bleeding control and hemostasis, then we can apply biocompatible bulb dressing material. And the most important factor, زي ما راح نشوف بالدراسات اللي راح نعرضها, إنه الكورونال سيل against reinfiltration of oral bacteria is of prime importance for the success of bulbectomy treatment. Because once this coronal seal disintegrated or lost, that's mean انه بصير في عندي contamination of the underlying pulp. وكنا بنعرف ككهاش study اللي عمل bulb exposure germ free rats و conventional rats. وجد انه بالجيرم فري راتس لما صار في عندي bulb exposure صار في عندي healing وصار في عندي dentine bridge formation وما صار في عندي inflammation in the pulp. Whereas بالconventional rats لما صار في عندي exposure للاورال بكتيريا صار في عندي inflammation وbulbar necrosis. That's mean our enemy is bacteria that comes from the oral cavity leading to inflammation and devitalization of the pulp. So by provision of a good coronal seal, that's mean the success of vital bulb therapy will be better and associated with better prognosis. Calcium hydroxide, we know two formula, BG base and catalyst. It is applied to the area of bulb exposure, and it was used by CaliScan in two different studies for teeth with reversible and irreversible bulbitis, and teeth with hyperplastic bulbitis, and even teeth with peribical lesion with highly favorable outcome. But these studies are old, and it was conducted in 1993 and 1995. Now with the invention of better calcium silicate material, MTA is better to be used as a bulb capping agent. Comparison of calcium hydroxide in MTA, this is a clinical study that was conducted by Lin Sawanu 2011. He compared between behavior of MTA and calcium hydroxide as direct bulb capping agent, as partial bulbotomy and full bulbotomy. And as we see, based on the result of this clinical research, that in direct bulb capping, MTA was better than calcium hydroxide. In partial bulbotomy, calcium hydroxide was better than MTA, whereas in full bulbotomy, calcium hydroxide and MTA, with their clinical behavior were similar to each other. This is all of us know the technique of direct bulb capping using calcium hydroxide. As we see in this clinical photo, we have the shadow of the underlying bulb. Almost here we have minimal or miniature bulb exposure. I did direct bulb capping using calcium hydroxide. Then I provide composite restoration as a coronal seal. معلومة كثير حابب أحكيها إنه regarding الأسنان اللي بنعملها some form of vital bulb therapy, whether it is direct bulb capping or partial bulbotomy, إنه don't rely on the patient complaint. يعني by phone calling, إنه نحكي مع المريض ونقول له سنك ما بوجع is not sufficient to evaluate the success of our treatment provided. لازم نجيب المريض ونعمل له vitality testing, ونعمل له percussion وpalpation وvisual examination, because some teeth that received such form of treatment may undergo unnoticed bulb necrosis. يصير في عندي devitalization of the underlying bulb that will lead, if left untreated, to development of peri-apical periodontitis. فمهم كثير انه هاي الاسنان نعملها good recall and follow up. This is a form of MTA direct bulb capping. This is a lower right seven with distal bulb horn exposure. I did gray MTA direct bulb capping since the bleeding was controlled and the bleeding is not active. So we can go, that's mean, you know, the underlying bulb is healthy or at worst condition, reversibly inflamed. That's mean it's able to undergo healing and repair. MTA bulbotomy. Whether Spoon in 2006, I mean, the case series outcome assessment, MTA was used as a bulbotomy agent for 23 teeth and 18 patients. The teeth were symptomatic and bulbary exposed either due to caries or trauma. The mean time for recall was 19.7 months. Of the 19 teeth that were available at recall, 15 involved healed teeth and 3 involved teeth that were healing. One of the 19 cases involved a tooth with persistent disease. يعني فقط واحد من 19 سن اللي تم علاجهم كان في عنده was considered as failure. That means it's a high success rate. Histological assessment, as we know, is the most accurate method. بهاي الدراسة في عندي 14 permanent molars were assigned to be extracted due to orthodontic reasons. فعملوا MTA bulbotomy وعملوا recall examination. انه immediately after they did bulbotomy treatment وجدوا انه كل الاسنان كانت asymptomatic وhistologic observation بعد ما عملوا extraction للteeth that all teeth had complete dentine protoformation with vital bulb that were free from inflammation. هاي الدراسة تمت by Iqbal. It was published in the Australian Endodontic Journal 2009 for MTA bulbotomy of a human permanent molars with irreversible bulbitis. By going back into our research, إنه كان في عندي 43 patient و 52 teeth. هذول الأسنان كانوا موزعين regarding different demographic and preoperative variables according to the age and gender and bulbal diagnosis. من هذول الأسنان كان عندي 44 teeth with irreversible bulbitis وكان في عندي 14 teeth with apical periodontitis present. We did bulbotomy treatment for these teeth and we followed them radiographically and clinically for 3 years and some of these teeth more than 3 years. Inclusion criteria in permanent molar diagnosis, whether it is reversible or irreversible bulbitis with or without pre-apical refraction. والتوث لازم يكون كمان it should be restorable وما عندي يكون عندي medical history عشان standardization between patients. Clinical protocol و conventional local anesthesia with lidocaine 2% with 1/100,000 epinephrine ورابر دام isolation from the beginning and disinfection of the operative field. ولازم نستخدم 2 بيرز. المعلومة اللي حابب احكي لكم اياها انه البير المستخدمة هاي سبيد بالانيشال drilling or excavation of caries. Once I get very close to the bulb, I have to change this bear into a sterile one because we are dealing with a connective bulb tissue that is sterile. We don't want any further coronal contamination of the underlying bulb. A technique in amputation of the bulb tissue in the bulb chamber to the level of root canal orifice with round diamond bear in a high speed handpiece. Why? It is in a high-speed handpiece or diamond bear, round diamond bear, because we want to do shredding. We don't want to disintegrate the integrity of the radicular bulb tissue. We need our cut to be sharp, and it should be sharp and sterile, because we don't want to disrupt the architecture of the underlying radicular bulb. نستخدم sodium hypochlorite. The concentration that was used in our research was 2.5. To the bulbal wound for hemostasis for 5 minutes. Then we go for adequate control of bleeding. Otherwise, root canal treatment was started. The form of MTA that was used, it was the gray MTA angulus, and we temporized the teeth with IRM. Then 1 week later, we bring the patient back and they provide the coronal restoration that is composed of resin modified glass enamel and coronal restoration, either composite or amalgam. Regarding the technique, as we see in our clinical photos, this is immediately after the roofing and excision of the coronal bulb tissue. And this is bulb stump with established hemostasis. And how we established hemostasis? By application of a cotton billet with a slight pressure over the vital bulb stump for 3 to 5 minutes. Then we should have a vital bulb radicular tissue that is of no or minimal bleeding. A slight oozing of the blood is acceptable because as we know that all calcium silicate material are hydrophilic. That means they sit in the presence of moisture. Then we go for application of a gray MTA. Mixed according to the manufacturer instructions with distilled water. Then we apply also wet cotton billet over MTA for double hydration. Then we temporize the tooth for 1 week to observe patient symptoms. Then we bring the patient back for provision of the coronal restoration. This is an example of, here I have deep caries that is nearly approaching the bulb with bulb exposures, multiple bulb exposures, soft caries dentine. So we did de-roofing and excision of the coronal bulb tissue. This is the vital bulb stump in the mesial and distal roots. This is the biodentine application. Also, biodentine can be used as a vital bulk therapy agent with cotton, then IRM, bringing the patient back, then for a provision of coronary restoration. With a newly developed MTA formulation, we can go for immediate session vital bulk therapy because we have some accelerators added to this material, so we can go for provision of the coronary restoration maybe 10 or 15 minutes after the capping of the underlying bulb because it starts to sit for this material. We can proceed with application of double layer or resin modified glass enamel and composite restoration or amalgam. Yes, and vital bulb therapy can be done in single session. Hi, video. I will show you this video for white MTA bulbotomy of symptomatic bulb after the roofing of the bulb chamber and hemorrhage control. We apply the white MTA with a slight pressure using a micro brush that is used for composite. With cotton billet for slight packing of the white MTA over the bulb. Regarding the thickness of MTA, it should be not less than 2 millimeter. It should be from 2 to 4 millimeter for adequate physical barrier. A criteria of success of vital bulb therapy: the tooth should be asymptomatic, it should be functional, there should be no tenderness to palpation or percussion, there should also be no increased mobility, no sinus tract or soft tissue chains around the tooth, no intraradicular or extraradicular bathosis on radiographic examination, such as internal resorption, root canal obliteration, or periapical rarefaction. I will show you some clinical example that we did in our study. This is an example of upper first molar with carious exposure, exposing the bulb and periapical rarefaction associated with all three roots. And also this is an example of lower molar with carious exposure and periapical rarefaction, as we see here, related more to the mesial root. The preoperative, as I said previously, in your 44 teeth with irreversible bulbitis, rarefaction or periapical lesion was present in 14 teeth of the 52 teeth that were included in our study. The core staphic periapical index score system for assessment of teeth with periapical rarefaction, and if you have the normal periapex, one small change in bone structure, we graded as 2. 3, change in bone structure with some mineral loss. 4, periodontitis will defined area of periapical bone resorption. And we have also grade 5. And a summary of results at recall periods. 3 months, we followed up these treated teeth by vital bulb therapy at 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 3 years, and 1 to 7 months. That's mean long time recall. The result of this study showed that at 3 months, the outcome was 100% clinical success and about 90% radiographic success. At 6 months, it is 100% clinical success and 98% radiographic success. At 12 months, it is 100% clinical success and about 98% radiographic success. That's mean high success rate, both clinical and radiographic. At 3 years, it's about 93% clinical and radiographic success, which is approaching the conventional endodontic prognosis or outcome of treatment. And we compared our treatment result with the results of vital bulb therapy studies, which were comparable to each other. This is an example of lower right first molar with periapical rarefaction. Periapical score, it's about 4, related to both mesial and distal roots. And a 3-month recall showed complete healing of this periapical rarefaction. after doing vital bulb therapy or complete bulbotomy treatment, which is magnificent, magnificent. That means the radicular bulb was able to heal or to undergo regeneration and reformation of BDL space around the root abscess. And this is an example of lower right first molar with irreversible bulbitis and peribical refraction score 3. 6 month recall, radiograph, the refraction has disappeared with reconstitution of lamina dura. Peribical index score here, it turned from 3 to 1, as you see here, just by doing vital bulb therapy. And this is an example of lower second molar. As we see, we have a deep carious lesion with peribical refraction, score 4. After 6 months, the lesion related to second molar has completely healed. And this is a lower second molar with irreversible bulbitis and carious lesion encroaching the pulp. A 6 month recall radiograph after bulbotomy, the tooth is clinically asymptomatic with no peribical refraction and no internal resorption or obliteration. And the tooth still asymptomatic and functional with no pathologic tissue change, either intraradicular or extraradicular. And this is an example of upper first molar with irreversible bulbitis and peribical rarefaction, peribical rarefaction. The tooth is asymptomatic with complete healing and reformation of BDL space. This is an example of lower right first molar, as we see here, with carious lesion approaching the pulp and peribical rarefaction score 3. 3 month recall here, this is the X-ray. And this is a 6 month recall with further reduction in the size of the lesion. And D here is the 12 month recall radiograph. The peribical rarefaction has diminished in size with normal BDL and peribical score of 1. That means it turned from pathologic being in a pathological status, evidence as peribical bone dissolution or resorption. Here, it's now we have a normal BDL space around the mesial root after 1 year of treatment. And this is a lower right molar with deep filling in the class 1 composite and peribical refraction score 3. A labial 12-month recall after 1 year with complete healing of the peribical tissue and the peribical score is 1. Here an example of failed treatment. We have peribical refraction. After 1 year, it gets bigger in size. That's mean the underlying bulb undergo necrosis with development of such large peribical lesion. So even the tooth was asymptomatic and functional, root canal treatment instituted to treat an existing peribical periodontitis. This is a radiograph of for 15-year-old female with signs and symptoms suggestive of irreversible bulbitis and apical periodontitis in tooth 4-6. This is a B, immediate postoperative radiograph, and C, a three-year recall showing the advanced healing of apical periodontitis. Now it's the peribical index score, it's about 1. Hard tissue barrier formation in the distal canal. Here, it is visible here on the X-ray, and narrowing of the or calcification of the mesial root canal system. And this is the main drawback or the negative consequences of vital bulb therapy, reduction in the size of the root canal system that makes further conventional endodontics more difficult and needs magnification and illumination. Because we are living in the era of microscopic dentistry, this treatment becomes easier and applicable with the adventure of magnifying loops and dental operating microscope. Still, these teeth doable and operable. And this is an example of adult patient 36, عمر المريض. وكان في عنده symptoms of irreversible bulbitis and widening of BDL space. B, immediate postoperative radiograph at 3 years here. See, and D, the 4 year recall radiograph, as we see here with crowning of this tooth, is asymptomatic with normal periapex and hard tissue barrier formation in the distal canal. In the distal canal, surfing the hard tissue barrier formation and narrowing or calcification of the mesial root canal system, the tooth now has a metal ceramic crown restoration. In the discussion, the available tests and investigations are unable to determine the actual histological status of the pulp. So we are not, we are not able to accurately assess the status of the underlying bulbs based on the result of available clinical tests and investigations. But with the advent of a new biomaterial and our enhanced understanding of bulb biology and reparative response, application of adult bulbotomy may be an alternative option. The overall success rate in our research was about 92.7%, coinciding with the previous studies done for immature teeth, Linsawanut 2011, and superior to the outcome reported by Asghari et al. 2015 using calcium enriched mixture over 5 year follow up. I will show you the result of this study. Hard tissue barrier formation was noticed in 5 of 43 teeth in this study, compared to 10 of 26 teeth in a study by Al-Qadri et al. Yeah, that's mean, you know, hard tissue barrier formation was not available, was not visible in all treated teeth. This is the result of Asghari. This is a 5 year result of vital bulb therapy of mature permanent teeth with irreversible bulbitis. This is a multi-center randomized clinical trial, which is a high level of evidence. And they compared the number sample size can random 407 patients, and they divided the patients into two groups. Group one, vital bulb therapy with calcium enriched mixture, and the group two is root canal treatment. And the result showed that the 5 year result revealed no significant difference in the success of both study arms. يعني ما في عندي فرق ذو دلالة إحصائية ما بين ال RCT والبلبوتومي treatment. The patient's age, gender, يعني ما له علاقة الايج. So we can do this form of treatment for adult patient. They didn't affect the outcome, and the presence of preoperative periapical lesion also didn't implement a significant effect in both groups. يعني the presence of periapical pathosis or lesion is not a contraindication for vital bulb therapy. The conclusion of this clinical research, as an alternative for RCT, vital bulb therapy with calcium enriched mixture can be considered as a valid treatment for vital mature permanent molars clinically diagnosed with irreversible bulbitis. This study was done by Linsawanut. Treatment outcome of mineral trioxide aggregate bulbotomy in vital permanent teeth with carious bulb exposure, retrospective study. The MTA bulbotomy was performed in 66 vital permanent teeth with carious bulb exposure, including teeth with signs and symptoms of irreversible bulbitis and the presence of periapical radiolucency. The significance of this research showed that teeth with carious bulb exposure can be treated successfully by MTA bulbotomy. Clinical signs of irreversible bulbitis and the presence of periapical radiolucency should not be considered contraindication for bulbotomy. يعني هاي المهمة والخلاصة من هاي الدراسة إنه الأسنان اللي فيهم التهاب لب غير انعكاسي والأسنان اللي فيهم التهاب بالآفة الذروية ممكن علاجها عن طريق البلبوتومي تريتمنت. البارشل بلبوتومي in mature permanent teeth with clinical signs indicative of irreversible bulbitis. This is also a randomized clinical trial. This study was done by Professor Dr. Nasreen Taha and Zamina Dr. Muhammad Al-Khazali. They compared the outcome of treatment either using calcium hydroxide or MTA as a partial bulbotomy agent for mature permanent teeth. The result or the conclusion of this study showed that MTA partial bulbotomy sustained a good success rate over the 2 year follow up in mature permanent teeth clinically diagnosed with irreversible bulbitis. More than half of the calcium hydroxide cases failed within 2 years. So this is the difference in the outcome of treatment either using MTA or calcium hydroxide. Now, calcium hydroxide is not physically stable as MTA. Also, the MTA is biocompatible material that is able to enhance dentine bridge formation that is of a great quantity and quality or better quality than calcium hydroxide. And this is of the treated cases by partial bulbotomy treatment. Lower left second molar in a 21-year-old female with a clinical diagnosis of irreversible bulbitis. The preoperative peripheral radiograph, the postoperative peripheral radiograph after MTA partial bulbotomy, 12 months after 1 year, we see here no obliteration, no intraradicular change, no peripheral bone resorption. And here is the 28-month follow-up radiograph. Still the tooth vital, still the tooth functional, no tenderness to percussion, no soft tissue change, no increased mobility. So this form of treatment also is valid for mature permanent teeth with irreversible bulbitis. Whether to do partial bulbotomy or complete bulbotomy treatment and depend on the extent of coronal bulb tissue inflammation. If we excise portion of the coronal bulb tissue, here they excise the mesial bulb horn corresponding to the area of exposure. And we were able to establish bleeding control. That means the distal horn of the bulb tissue is intact or at least reversibly inflamed that is able to undergo healing and repair. فبيحتمد على the extent of inflammation, whether to do partial bulbotomy or complete bulbotomy treatment. This study conducted recently, 2021, they compare two forms of treatment, non-surgical endodontics and vital bulb therapy for management of mature permanent mandibular molar with symptomatic irreversible bulbitis and apical periodontitis. Then two groups. For each group, they assigned 30 teeth. The result of this study showed that the success rate was 90% in the non-surgical root canal treatment group and 93.3% in the non-surgical root canal treatment and vital bulb therapy group. And in the same tooth, they did vital bulb therapy for example, the mesial root and the distal root, conventional endodontics. According to an intergroup comparison between the proportion of teeth healed and non-healed, there was no significant difference between these two forms of treatment, whether to do vital bulb therapy or non-surgical endodontics. The combination of non-surgical endodontic treatment and vital bulb therapy is a viable biologically based, minimally invasive treatment option for multi-rooted mandibular teeth with symptomatic irreversible bulbitis and apical periodontitis. As we see here, this study was published in Journal of Endodontics 2021. That's mean, you know, that confirmed the result of our clinical research that this form of treatment is also valid for mature teeth with irreversible bulbitis and apical periodontitis. ليش ما يعني we don't practice vital bulb therapy as routine as conventional endodontics. لأن موضوع ال vital bulb therapy is not well researched as conventional endodontics. هاي ال Ellis Nieberger he said an internet PubMed search produced 144 adult bulbotomy papers. يعني فقط 144 دراسة most describing molar treatment in young adults. In contrast, traditional endodontics has well over 10,000 articles recommending traditional endodontics. يعني ما في عندي enough clinical research. رغم انه بالآونة الأخيرة عدد الدراسات عن الفيتال بلب ثيرابي بلشت تزيد and it all of most of these studies were clinical research. فعشان هيك انه معظم الدراسات انعملت على traditional endodontics مش على الفيتال بلب ثيرابي أو البلبوتومي تريتمنت. And this study was also was published by our teacher, Dr. Nasreen Taha, and it was a long-term follow-up of bulbotomy treatment for symptomatic mature permanent teeth with carious bulb exposure on a stain-proof calcium silicate-based material, a new form because it will not cause discoloration of the crown. The result of this study showed that full bulbotomy in cariously exposed bulb of mature permanent teeth sustained a high success rate over 4 years اي ثينك يعني ما في عندي معظم الدراسات على تراديشنال اندودونتكس معظمهم يعني 2 تو 3 تو 4 ييرز. هلا صار في عندنا دراسات عن الفايتال بلك ثيرابي يعني 5 and 4 ييرز. That's mean enough clinical and radiographic follow-up. Regarding the type of MTA material that was used, it was a new MTA plus. والage group can from 14 to 16 years old. هلا بقول لك ان the result of this study showed that the preoperative bulbar diagnosis was reversible in 39 teeth and irreversible bulbitis in 61. هلا number of the sample size it's about 100. هلا the cumulative survival rate of bulbotomy were generally high, it's about 98%. فthat means انه this form of treatment can be applied for mature permanent teeth with such type of bulbar and primical diagnosis. يعني ما في الان حجه تقول لي انه الفايتال بلب ثيرابي ما عليه دراسات سريريه، لا موجود دراسات سريريه عليه وهي with long term follow up and it proved to be this form of treatment is associated with high success rate. وهي يعني these radiographs were taken from this last clinical research that was done by Dr. Nasreen Taha. In the first arrow, as we see from A to C, this is the preoperative radiograph of 4-6 in 23-year-old woman diagnosed with irreversible bulbitis and the full bulbotomy was performed, as we see here, B, the immediate. And this is the six-month follow-up radiograph showing a new bulbar lesion around the mesial root. The tooth was tender to percussion. That means this form of treatment was considered as failure. And as we see here, that the root canal space is still visible in the mesial root. That means conventional endodontics still applicable. And the second row, which is D, the preoperative radiograph of tooth 4-7, as we see, this is a large deep carious exposure. And E here, the immediate post-operative, F, the 1 year follow-up of this second molar, and G, this is the 4 years, 6 months, the tooth was asymptomatic with a normal periapex. This, the last or the third row, this is the preoperative radiograph of this lower first molar in a 33-year-old woman diagnosed with irreversible bulbitis. A full bulbotomy was performed, and in K, here, this is the 4 year and 5 month. The tooth was crowned, as we see here, and asymptomatic with normal periapex. So that's mean a long term, a long duration of follow up, and still these teeth survive with no symptoms and still functional with no periapical pathosis. What's the added value of this bulbotomy treatment? We should do more bulbotomies in cases where our patient would otherwise have the tooth extracted due to economic consideration. يعني كثير بيجونا مرضى على العيادات وتكون أسنانهم بحاجة لعصب due to the high cost of good quality endodontics they are not able to afford for this complex form of treatment. ممكن نعطيهم option البلبوتومي، نعملهم نحكي للمريض أنا بحكي لمريضي يعني عملت أنا علاج عصب حيوي. هلا ال 1 gram of MTA is sufficient for 5 to 6 cases. Now يعني it costs about يعني the cost of treatment for each tooth, it's about $10. That's mean, you know, it's can be affordable by the patient, less costly, less expensive to the operator regarding time and effort than conventional endodontics. نحكي لهذا المريض في عندنا treatment options وبناء على الدراسات السريرية إنه success rate لهذا form of treatment is very high. فممكن نعطيه هذا option as an added value, as an alternative to do tooth extraction. Tooth extraction, زي ما بنعرف انه له functional consequences, the patient will not be able to eat, وله كمان aesthetic consequences, negative outcomes. So ممكن نعطي هذا التريتمنت اوبشن بديل عن الاكستراكشن. على 3 year recall, I don't have the immediate, I lost some of my X-ray data available at my dental office. حابب أورجيكم إنه هذا this tooth or this bulbotomy treatment was done in 2018 هون في كان الإي present and the 7 still not erupting. The patient called back into my office in 2021 with no complaints. The tooth is functional, no symptoms. Root canal space still evident or visible on X-ray, and the integrity of the coronary restoration is still intact. That's mean we have the adjacent teeth in full position, in full eruption. This is a form of abixogenesis. We enhanced development of complete root formation. هلا دكتور نرجع للمعضلة أو الدايليما اللي some of our colleagues complain about إنه how دكتور you treat a tooth with peripical refraction with bulbotomy treatment using either MTA or bidentine. هاي الكلينيكال كيس اوف 16 year old patient attend into dental office with symptoms suggestive of symptomatic irreversible bulbitis and symptomatic apical periodontitis as it is visible on the preoperative peripical X-ray. We have a peripical bathosis مبينة واضحة. We tested the tooth and it was vital, and I tested it without anesthesia. The underlying bulb was vital. I did excision or amputation of the coronal bulb tissue up to the level of root canal orifices. As we see here, the strict isolation is very important from the beginning to avoid contamination of the underlying bulb. Changing of the bear once I get the close into the underlying bulb also is very important. I have to excavate and clean all cavity walls from all caries to prevent or decrease contamination of the underlying bulb. Application of cotton billet with sodium hypochlorite with a slight pressure backing over the radicular bulb tissue. Biodentine application of 2 to 4 millimeter thickness, then a provision of the final restoration as a coronal seal to prevent reinfiltration of oral bacteria into the radicular root canal system will be associated with high success rate. And I inform the patient to go back for a clinical and radiographic follow-up. Hello, what is the conclusion of this presentation? Inshallah, ما كون طولت عليكم. In the MTA bulbotomy now, it is a treatment approach based on a clinical evidence. And most of the studies, we have many clinical studies that proved that this form of vital bulb therapy or bulbotomy treatment using calcium silicate material is associated with high success rate. So بالتالي احنا لما نعطي هذا المريض هذا treatment option, it is based on the clinical research. ووجود irreversible bulbitis will be peripical refraction provided that the tooth bulb is vital, لا يمنع من إجراء such form of conservative treatment. وإحنا بنعرف إنه conventional endodontics very difficult, very complex treatment procedure, very expensive to the patient. Many epidemiological studies with the invention of CBCT showed that even functional asymptomatic root canal treated teeth were associated with periapical lesion or a refraction. That's mean the success rate of conventional endodontics as it appear on the CBCT evaluation or assessment, it is lower than what appear or on periapical X-ray. If we conserve this radicular bulb tissue by provision of bulb dressing agent and the provision of the coronal seal, that means the underlying bulb will remain vital. It will provide damping and resiliency, and it will provide proprioception into the patient. So he will not exert too much occlusal load. That means it is a defensive mechanism from the proprioceptive nerve fibers. That means increase functionality and longevity of this tooth if it is compared to conventional endodontics. كثير بنسمع انه هذا الفايل بيعمل بريزرفيشن للبري سيرفايكال دنتين، وبنسمع عن التراس اكسس، وبنسمع عن النينجا اكسس. كل هاي التكنيكس just to conserve as much as we can from the coronal and radicular tooth tissue to minimize the fracture of these root canal treated teeth. If we conserve this radicular bulb tissue, we will be able to maintain the dentition into a longer period of time. وشكرا لكم جميعا على حسن الاستماع وإن شاء الله ما أكون أطلت عليكم، وأي استفسارات أو تساؤلات إحنا جاهزين، ويعطيكم العافية.